Mommy, Chisel Art Kolkata has just launched a brand new art magazine, Art Etc. Now, the significance of this magazine is that it emerges as one of the only publications from the East after decades. So what does the magazine have on offer? Take a look. After a long hiatus, Imami Chisel Art's magazine, Art Etc., emerges as a sole publication dedicated to the arts from Kolkata. While this publication stands as a much-needed platform for the representation of art practices from the East, the larger aim of the magazine is to include nationwide editorial content.
You see, the problem in India, especially in Calcutta, is that there's tremendous lack of discourse. Not that people don't write and read, but it doesn't come out in the open. So there's no platform to, you know, give your ideas and talk about it, discuss about it. So the primary purpose of any magazine should be to bring all these views together on various aspects of life and art and see if the discourse can be set in the public domain.
The highlights of this inaugural issue includes a special focus on contemporary art practices from the Northeast, an insightful article on the works of Bangladeshi artist Dhali Al-Mamoon, who has faced extraordinary situations to undertake a secularist position, and a major article on renowned artist and winner of the Artist Mundi Prize, N.S. Harsha. Other reads that did manage to engage readers focused on the art of the marginalized, such as Dalit art, interviews with collectors and reviews of significant exhibitions. While welcoming much-needed publications for art, experts, however, did see some room for improvement.
I just went through some of the articles, and they're also written by students who have just finished their PhD or in the middle of their PhD. So it offers them that space to kind of try out what it's like to really engage with this kind of public sphere. So I think it does them a lot of good. Standard is uneven, but I think it'll perhaps pick up later on. And there's also not very strong editorial voice, which kind of, you know, waters down the differences. So in that sense, each of the scholars or art historians or critics who've written, they have retained their own idiosyncratic style. So it's quite interesting.
Art Etc. will be published thrice a year and will cost you 150 rupees per copy. In today's forum, we have a very special guest, Vikram Bachawat, who is the director of Imami Chisel Art Kolkata. Welcome to the show, Mr. Bachawat. It's
Thank
a pleasure
you.
Having you.
Thank you.
Mr. Bachawat, the launch of Art Etc., it is significant because it does fill the void of art criticism and writings on art. But what really prompted you to launch an art magazine?
We thought, why not give a platform to the other artists, those who are not being highlighted in other magazines. And we wanted to do something very concrete, very creative. And according to us, art has no boundaries. We want to go international. In our next issue, you'll find a lot of international coverage too.
Is this going to be a pan-India sort of launch of Art Etc.?
In the first stage, we have Calcutta and Delhi. In the next issue, we'll be going to Mumbai.
Tubar.com.